Well, the Gold Coast is Australia's playground, but the glitz and glamour hide an underbelly of crime and criminal behaviour. A new series is about to shine a light on what really happens on the streets of the Gold Coast. Let's have a quick look.
As the stolen car moves ahead of them at the traffic lights, Travis and George pounce.
Get out of the vehicle! Get out of the vehicle!
The driver's just gone straight through those lights and cleaned up another car.
The desperate thief leaves a trail of destruction as he eludes police once again.
Superintendent Jim Keogh is tasked with keeping the streets of the Gold Coast safe. He's in our Gold Coast studio while Samuel Johnson narrates the series, couldn't you tell? And he joins us now from Melbourne. Gentlemen, thank you very much for your time. Jim, we'll start with you. You are the top cop, I suppose, of the Gold Coast's Rapid Action Patrol Group. What exactly does that entail and what sort of crimes are you involved with on a daily basis? It'd be pretty varied, I'd imagine.
Yeah, look, I've got 100 staff down there at Varsity Central here on the Gold Coast. Wide variety of crimes, but we're used to taking out the criminal motorcycle gang element. We've diversified a little bit, still doing high-level crime here on the Gold Coast. Rapid response, first car there, that sort of stuff.
And Jim, we've seen a huge amount of criminal activity on the Gold Coast recently with obviously the bikie wars that have been going on. And at one point, I think that they actually, a bunch of people sort of surrounded a police station. It was really getting hairy, hence the crackdown. What sort of dangers do cops on the beat face just on a daily basis?
Look, there's a lot of danger, and certainly that's appropriate this time of the year. We're getting to Remembrance Day for the police. Here on the coast, we lost Damien Leading a couple of years ago. Sergeant Gary Hamry was shot here also on the coast, so there's danger in every day. And you talk about the situation with the bikies. Well, yes, they did surround the police there at Broadbeach. Bravely, to a person, the police didn't take a backward step.
Incredible job indeed. Now, Samuel, you are a Melbourne boy. You narrate the series. Have you had a chance to sort of get up close and personal with the job that the police are doing up on the Gold Coast?
Yeah, I was able to fly up there and spend some time with the RAP unit, do some ride-alongs, try on all their gear and basically annoy them for a couple of days. It was an eye-opener, for sure.
In what way?
Well, just how scary it is, really. I mean, I don't really know how they do it, kind of staying so close to that kind of thin blue line. I think if I was at the coalface like they are, then you'd probably end up finding me in a corner sucking my thumb and calling for mum.
But I'm wondering, and I'm not sure if you guys can answer this question, from a television-making perspective, do people have to give their permission to be shown on this show if they're arrested in the street? Or do people say, no, I don't want to? How do you process that? Do you have a sign, like at the airport, shooting today, filming? How does it work?
No, look, they don't have to give their permission in relation to this. There's TV crews filming here on the Gold Coast all the time. You know, the news bulletins are going up and down the highway, or the news cars going up and down the highway. So only time for concern as far as permission goes is if they're juveniles. And, of course, we don't film in their home.
Yeah, well, one of my first jobs in TV was as a cub reporter from Prime News on the Gold Coast, and the cops sort of want to get their job done. What made you go, yep, come on board, we want to show you what life is like as an officer on the Gold Coast? What made you get into the project?
Look, we've had some horrible press over the 12-month period, and I say that in fairness to all journos and all media. The Broadbeach brawl went international and certainly didn't portray the coast in a fair light. And I think that was the catalyst for why we actually took the series on. So we can see the flip side of what's actually happening as far as police goes. You know, we're going to see crime in the paper, we're going to see it on TV, and we're certainly going to hear about it on the radio. It's time that we actually showed what the police here on the Gold Coast are doing about crime. Great opportunity for us.
How are those men and women in your squad feeling about being TV stars?
Yeah, look, I think they acquit it to it pretty well, a lot better than I do.
And, Jim, just quickly on that, you talk about that there was a real terrible year, and we know about the crackdown that ensued that turned the tide. What is the situation like on the Gold Coast now with the bikie wars?
Yeah, totally different landscape. Here we are 12 months out from the riot in Broadbeach. You wouldn't credit it's the same place. It's a safe environment for the families. It's safe on the streets. The crackdown has done wonders for tourism, done wonders for commerce. Couldn't speak highly enough of it. And whilst it's easy to acknowledge the great work the police have done here, let's be realistic, they're armed with some pretty strong legislation.
Indeed. And Samuel, just on a different point now, you of course came into Studio 10 talking about some fundraising that you were doing for your sister and with your beautiful sister Connie. How's she going?
Oh, I'm really pleased to report that that she's doing really well.
And
hopefully that continues for as long as possible.
Oh, that's such God good bless. News.
Yeah, it's wonderful news, Sam. Hey, Sam Johnson and Superintendent Jim Keogh, thank you very much for joining us today. We really, really appreciate it. And that Gold Coast Pops premieres tonight on Network 10 at 7:30. So make sure you don't miss it.
Fantastic.